So this drawing shows a funnel on top of a flask. And so basically this is making up a pyramid shape. This pyramid shape is going to be a graphical representation of the structure of a scientific paper. So I'm going to redraw this hourglass shape and talk about how to tell a good story in your scientific journal article. The top part of the pyramid represents the introduction. And you see it starts out very wide at the top, and as you go through the introduction section, it becomes more narrow. What this represents is the way you're presenting information. At the beginning, it's going to be more general, and as you move through the introduction, you're going to become more and more specific in the information that you are presenting. Now, the first few paragraphs of the introduction are going to establish the current knowledge in the field. And you're going to do that by using knowledge bricks, or, you know, little bits of information about what's known, and supporting that information with references. And so you're going to stack these knowledge bricks together to build up a wall of knowledge. So references 1, 2, 3, and 4 are used to build part of the wall of knowledge. References 5 through 9 are used to build another part of the wall. And then 10, 11, 12 are building another part of the wall of knowledge. Now what you notice is that between these parts of the wall of knowledge, there are gaps. So there's information that we don't know as a field. These are the knowledge gaps or the unknowns. And so the purpose of the introduction, one of the purposes, is to point out these unknowns or knowledge gaps. You'll have one or maybe two in your introduction. And then you're going to design a research question that's going to fill those knowledge gaps when you answer that research question. And so the knowledge gaps should logically lead to the research question. And to carry out the work of answering the research question, you'll break it down into some objectives. The next part of the scientific journal article would be the materials and methods section, followed by the results section. And those are represented by the straight part of the funnel, because they're relatively straightforward. You're not going more specific or less specific during these sections. So the materials and methods should be presented in a way such that they match up well with the objectives that were proposed at the end of the introduction. And then they should flow into the results. Now, these results should reflect back to the objectives that you pointed out in the introduction. That's what this red arrow is representing. And after the results section, we will move into the discussion section. The discussion section should start out very specific, and that's why it's narrow at the top. And then as you move through the section, it's going to become more generalized. That's why it's wider at the bottom. The first part of the discussion section should present the major new knowledge that you have found, and that should reflect back to the objectives and the research question that were stated in the introduction. As you move through the rest of the discussion section, you will discuss other new knowledge that you have found, and you will talk about how that new knowledge relates to the knowns that you talked about in the introduction, how it fills the knowledge gaps, and how it creates new understanding in your field.